Hello, my name is Patrice Pajusco. I work for Institut Mines-Télécom Atlantique, a French engineering school located in Brittany and part of the Institut Mines-Télécom. This video is about an ampling demonstration of spatial modulation presented on the Orange Stand during the International Conference on Communications in Paris in 2017. This work has been done in the framework of a collaborative project. It is entitled Spatial Modulation and is led by the Orange Company. The project, supported by the French Research Agency, involves Orange, Centrale Supélec, Institut d'électronique et de télécommunication de Rennes, Institut Langevin, and Institut Mines-Télécom Atlantique. For more information, you can contact the project leader by email, Dintui Fanui, or you can visit the project website. The next generation of mobile system will include massive MIMO base stations. In this context, the spatial modulation is a promising technique because the complexity could be moved to the base stations. This implies that the device will have a low complexity and a low power consumption. Moreover, two parallel streams could be generated with just a single radio transmitter chain. Thus, high data rate could be offered. This demonstration aims at showing the principle of the spatial modulation. On this picture, the overview of the equipment is presented. The prototype works at 2.4 GHz. On the transmitter side, a pure tone is transmitted for the demonstration of spatial modulation. In a real communication system, this carrier could transmit information with a classical modulation such as QAM or QPSK. This pure tone is connected to an array designed by the Orange Company. You can see here the 8 antennas, which represent the 8 spatial modulation symbols. On the other side, you have an RF switch with 8 output connected to the 8 antennas. So just one antenna will be selected at a given time. 3 bits are required to select one antenna among the 8. This can be done with 3 push buttons representing the binary value of the selected antenna. On the receiver side, a massive array and a channel sounder are used. Both were designed by Institut Mines-Télécom Atlantique. The 64 antenna array has 32 elements in horizontal polarization and 32 in vertical polarization. This is similar to the antenna complexity of future massive MIMO base stations. The channel sounder is based on a software-defined radio receiver controlled in real time by the PC. Let's move to the graphical user interface of the channel sounder. This part of the screen displays in real time the complex received signal on each antenna. One square is dedicated to the amplitude and the other one is dedicated to the phase. The color bars of the amplitude and phase are plotted in dB and degree respectively. The signature of each spatial modulation symbol is stored above. Here, just the first 5 has been learned. The correlation between the received signal and the different symbols is plotted on the right. Red represents a perfect correlation of 1, and blue a correlation below 0.5. Finally, the symbol with the highest correlation value is displayed just above. This is an example of static channel recorded just before the opening of the conference. If I don't move, you can see that the amplitude and phase of the channel is really stable. Now an example during the day with people moving around. The channel is changing a little more. If now I move my hand close to the transmit antenna, you can see that the channel is changing. The same effect appears if I move my hand close to the base station antenna. If I stop, the channel becomes stable. Now we can have a look on the signature. If we move to the second antenna, we have another signature. The signature of the channel is different. If I release and go back to the first antenna, we find again the first signature. So we have two antennas configuration, two signatures. If we learn the first antenna, you have a good correlation, as you can see here. If we move to the second antenna, the correlation disappears. That's the basic idea. We can learn the second antenna, and you can see that you have a good correlation on the second symbol. If I release and go back to the first antenna, we have a good correlation on the first symbol. Now we can increase the complexity and learn the different antennas. So one by one, we select the one of the eight antenna and the signature is stored in the base station. Okay, now the eight symbols are learned and known by the base station, and we can try to select a different antenna and see what is decoded by the receiver. And as you can see on this example, it works. For instance, 010, 110, 011. In each case, the good value is decoded at the receiver. So we can also try to move a little. If I move my hand close to the antenna, you can see that the correlation is changing, but it remains high enough to avoid any mistake by decoding the symbol. That's the advantage of having many antennas at the base station. This video presented an experimental and visual proof of concept of transmit spatial modulation with massive MIMO antenna at the receiver side and compact antennas at the transmitter side. With just a single RF chain, spatial modulation could provide high data rate with two independent streams. By moving the complexity to the base station, the device could have a low complexity and a low power consumption. Future work will investigate spatial modulation performances by using simulations and dynamic channel measurements. To conclude, the project team would like to thank all the visitors for their interest and questions about the spatial modulation. If you have any questions, or if you have any interest in this video, please do not hesitate to contact me. My email address will be displayed in the next slide. Thank you.